Hi friends, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Carla Joy. I'm a thrift decorator enthusiast, and this is Joy in a Nutshell. So in this video, guys, I'm going to be showing you how to turn just two plain pieces of wood and this very old picture into farmhouse signs, two that can be used all year round and one for seasonal. This is a sander that I used for this project. I bought it at Home Depot for less than $30. You don't have to use a sander for this project, or if you don't have a sander, you could actually use just plain sandpaper. But again, you don't have to. I wanted to because I'm going to be using some pieces of wood that are pretty raw. So right away, I started sanding my projects. I'm using, I think, 120 grit sandpaper on this sander. I decided to sand my projects, like I said, because I'm using raw pieces of wood, some of which have never been sanded before, so I just wanted to kind of smooth them out a little bit. I decided to sand this one because it had a picture on it and I wanted to get that picture off. Again, you don't have to sand them, but you can also paint over them, but I decided to sand mine. Here I'm actually using a paint sample that I actually got from a garage sale. It is a flat finish. It's kind of like a whitish cream color, and I'm using this 2-inch brush, which has seen better days, but trust me, it's going to do the job just fine. I just wanted to get an even layer of paint on my project. I'm making sure to paint the front and all sides, and I'm just going to leave the back as is. And then I decided to paint the second piece because it was kind of uneven from my great sanding skills. So I just wanted an even base, and then I also wanted to apply some of the paint to the sides where it's black. So then I decided to also give my first piece a second coat just to give it a more opaque full coverage. So this is what I'm doing here. So after painting all my projects, I decided that I wanted to use this printable that I got offline and some Mod Podge. I applied the Mod Podge to the surface of this piece very thinly, and then once I had my Mod Podge on there, I then applied my printable, and I wanted to just make sure that it was even and in the middle. Once I did this, I also used a credit card or just a plastic Kroger card or an ID to smooth out all the bubbles, and for some reason I didn't get that on film. So my apologies.
So once you
there,
have all of your air bubbles out, the air bubbles out from
underneath,
you're
going to go
basically.
Ahead and take the Mod Podge and you're going to apply it thinly to the top of the picture and just make sure that it's evenly applied. Once everything dries, you're going to want to sand it down. I wanted mine to look really distressed and worn, so I did a lot of sanding on this. And then this is what I came up with. I decided that I wanted to add some florals to my picture, so I took these two baby's breath and I applied them with some E6000. I applied one bushel to one side and then I apply another bushel to the other. Once I get them on there evenly and where I want them, I then decided to apply two pieces of paper over the bundles of floral so that they do look like bundles and the glue adheres better and they stay on the photo better. And I really like the way this came out and it's ready for fall. For my next project, I actually just printed some letters on a Word document, and then I cut them out really carefully using scissors. You can use an X-Acto knife for this, but I didn't have one on hand. Once I have all of my letter cut out, I went ahead and lined them up on my piece just to see what it looked like. And then once again, I'm going to take my Mod Podge and I'm going to apply it evenly to my project that I'm working on. And then I'm going to carefully apply my letters just because they are skinnier letters. I actually want to be extra careful, and I'm actually going to also be working in sections to apply my letters. Once I've applied all of my letters, I'm going to go over each letter with a very thin layer of Mod Podge. And I'm just so thrilled with the way this came out. I've been wanting to purchase a sign like this for a really long time. On my third and final project, I actually used these charcoal sticks, paint pens, and a permanent marker. I start by shading the back of my image with the charcoal sticks so as to use it as sort of a carbon copy or a transfer paper. I go over that with a pen or a pencil, and I end up with something that looks like this. Once I have that image on my project, I'm going to start using my paint markers or paint pens. I actually went the cheap route on my paint pens, and I don't recommend that. You can buy really decent paint pens or paint markers at Hobby Lobby with a coupon, and I went the cheap route, and I had to go over this image like 4 times, and I usually only have to do it twice with a really good one. But basically what I'm doing is I'm tracing my image that I created with my charcoal sticks on the back of my image, and then I'm going to go over that several times until I get the darkness that I want on the white. Once I have that, I fill all of my letters in, and I'm actually going to go over and around the letters with the permanent marker as to make the letters stand out more. And I'm just so happy with the way this came out. I put it on the back of my stove. So there you go, guys. Mod Podge transfer. Charcoal sticks transferred and then traced with paint markers and a permanent marker. And you get beautiful signs that cost nearly nothing for your home. If this is a video that interests you and you'd like to see more, please subscribe to my channel, leave a comment below, and like this video. I hope to see you back. Bye.